Beijing, China. There are 5 million cars on the roads here. It's one of the most congested cities in the world. Traffic conditions have become so bad that they threaten urban functions. Accidents are common in the closely spaced intersections. They make bad traffic conditions even worse. Pedestrians and bicyclists are forced off the streets by the cars. Heated arguments result. It seems a bicycle and a motorcycle have collided. The increased number of cars on the road has adversely affected people's health. Particulates from car exhaust are a serious problem. Measurements near a main road in Beijing show particulate concentrations more than 5 times higher than those found in Tokyo. They can be harmful to human health if inhaled over an extended period of time. What countermeasures can be taken to improve the situation? This municipal bureau monitors Beijing's traffic conditions 24 hours a day. The most important component of Beijing's road system are the 4 major ring roads that encircle the city. The outermost 5th ring road is 100 kilometers long. The monitors show traffic congestion in red, in real time. Traffic jams on the ring roads have an instant ripple effect on other roads. The municipal government is building new arterial roads, including a 200-kilometer expressway scheduled to open by 2015. Another countermeasure is public bicycles. Bicycles are placed at various locations in the city in an attempt to reduce the number of cars being driven. Various measures have been tried in the past, such as the establishment of bus lanes and restrictions based on license plate numbers to reduce traffic, but these have been largely ineffectual. What's at the heart of the worst traffic congestion in the world? How do people feel about it and live with it? This is a portrait of Beijing during one 24-hour period in the summer. It's 6:30 in the morning, commuters from the suburbs begin driving into the city on the arterial roads. The giant metropolis of Beijing awakens. Average speed during the morning rush is about 10 kilometers per hour. We focus in on a taxi driver. Cui Jiehua has been a taxi driver for 15 years. He reports on traffic conditions to a local radio station. Taxi drivers operating in the city provide information that's used in radio traffic reports.
再为您插播一下刚刚收到的路况，京通快速路高碑店桥到四惠桥东向西的方向目前的车型缓慢。我们这个司机，就平常人问今天是什么车号限行啊？今天的限行尾号是4和9，提醒您呢一定要遵照执行。
哎，如果说不是硬性给的呀，就是让每个家庭去自个儿去挑车牌的话，很少有挑尾号4的。所以说这一天呢，限行的车辆就比较那什么，多少一点，道路啊容易堵一点。At 8 o'clock, Jiehua picks up his first passenger of the day.
没事，可以上。
The passenger works for a Japanese-owned company. He's on his way to Tokyo and needs to get to Beijing Airport, which is 30 kilometers away. For Jiehua, the long-distance fare is a good start to the day.
我很羡慕东京的马路啊。东京它这个公共交通非常发达，所以呢，东京基本上白天是没有堵车的，啊。
3 minutes after picking up his passenger, Jiehua gets caught in a traffic jam.
哎，现在堵车赶得上飞机吗？是飞机是多？飞机是10点50了，没问题。反正每天这样都习惯了。对，习惯成自然了，已经。习惯。春节的时候，有时候开车，在三环路上跑80迈。
Today is Tuesday, the worst traffic day of the week. After 30 minutes of driving, they've gone only 6 kilometers. They still have to go more than 20 kilometers to get to the airport. Jiehua drives his cab in the city every day, but even for him, the traffic this morning is worse than expected. This is an important long-distance fare that will bring in nearly 100 yuan, or about $16. But Jiehua can't ignore his appointment with a regular customer. Jiehua decides to ask another driver to take his passenger to the airport.
我一会儿待会儿还接病人，我怕赶不回来了就。好嘞，二哥，我知道了。那麻烦你师傅待会儿。没事，没事，没事，我给您送点。没事，没事，没事。好，谢谢，再见。Jiehua
manages to transfer his passenger to another cab.
不堵车的话，应该说时间，前后能凑能赶上，堵车就来不及了，因为马上我不知道机场那边，有没有事儿。 因为有时候机场高速也容易堵。
这种情况
Jiahua got a good customer first thing in the morning, but in the end, all of the payment went to the other cab driver.
但是不多，不是特别多。
多啊！好，现在的车公庄大街西向东行驶缓慢，圆明园西路的北向南拥堵，刘家窑桥南向北车。
It's now past 10 a.m. The morning rush has ended, but the roads are getting crowded again. Cars flood the streets driven by people doing their daily errands.
Sir, 早上好。
早上好。
去哪儿？这是？
我去同仁医院。
哦，看病去啊。
啊，对，看病去。
今天够热的啊。
天还疼，
注意安全。
好嘞，
这是去哪儿？去玩去吗？
对，带着家人去天安门。
我说这够堵的哈。
堵，反正经常这样吧，上下班时间吧。
习惯了是吧？
啊。因为平时我出来的比较早。
哦，就
对，这两天休假带他们玩一下，出来的比较晚。
好的好的。
够热的，
够热的。你这去哪儿？
我呀，
对，
刚从顺义回来。
哦，
我在西单住。
哦。
To address the ever-worsening problem of congestion in the city, Beijing's municipal government monitors all traffic conditions around the clock. The road network centers on the ring roads. There are also 16 subway lines with a total of 450 kilometers of track. Buses also run regular routes.Regarding the roads, over 1,000 cameras have been installed in the city to monitor traffic. Red indicates traffic congestion. One monitor shows that an accident has occurred on a ring road. This is the West Second Ring Road.The red portions rapidly increase as traffic jams expand. The congestion on the ring road quickly spreads to nearby streets. Cars are gridlocked here on West Second Ring Road.People have started calling situations like this "dusu," which means fenced-in death. They used to call it "duche," or fenced-in car, but now with cars bumper to bumper, it feels more like getting buried alive. Making our way between the blocked cars, we find that the accident occurred on a curb.Where motorists enter the ring road from a city street. This was the cause of the fenced-in death. Dr. Wang Rui.Is a traffic engineer. He has researched traffic congestion in Beijing for many years. Dr. Wang has identified one design flaw as a factor that contributes both to the large number of accidents and the terrible congestion in Beijing.
我们说这里是一个通向二环主路的一个入口，二环主路是设计速度80公里的高速公路。我们说这里进入二环主路的车辆完全没有加速车道，他们就这么直接切入二环主路。这样的话，他们和主路上行驶的汽车之间的速度差非常的大，会影响主路的通行能力。
This problem is found in countless places around Beijing. Another source of trouble is the fact that the ring roads aren't elevated.
另外，在城市的中心地区修这样宽的高速公路，也是一种落后于时代的做法，也是欧美国家在1950年代和1960年代为止的一种做法。所以这里的交通量比较大，也是这个立交桥发生交通堵塞的一个主要原因。
Beijing is growing rapidly. New roads continue to be built, adding to the current total of 27,000 kilometers. Dr. Wang says that this pattern of development has structural problems that create gridlock.Jianhua, the taxi driver, is in the center of the city, having given rides to three passengers during the morning.
Hi.
还要拍摄我的工作的一天，所以说您帮个忙。
你好，您好，没事。
谢谢哈。
嗯，好，没事。
This mother and son are going to meet a relative at the railway station.
那个南广场什么地儿您要去？
就南广场，我去接个人。
好嘞。
The station is about 5 kilometers away. They've decided to take a cab because the subway is inconvenient at this location.
说这个叔叔可以录你的，可以说两句话。你喜欢坐出租不？
有点喜欢。
哪儿堵车哪儿不堵车，完了呢被评定为沟通之星之后，这个信息源呢从沟通之星里边再提拔出来。哎，
像我们上班一般都自如，可是像我们因为住的比较靠里嘛，只能坐地铁，因为上班比较远。你要是开车回来就不用上班了。你看那车里面都是一个人开一个车，我觉得应该限制让一个人别开车，太浪费了。
They arrive at Beijing West Railway Station. It took 20 minutes to drive 5 kilometers.
没说他还没出来的吧？您把我拉到能停的地儿，您走就行。
好，行，好的。
嗯。
一共十五。
给您。
The total is 15 yuan, not much above the initial fare. It's equivalent to $2.5. Jianhua's total earnings for the morning are a modest $15. Gridlock makes it difficult for taxi drivers to earn a living. To help them, the city government raised the initial fare in June of this year.
收入应该说目前为止，通过这次调价之后，应该说收入还是有的。收入比过去最起码每月得收入多收入1000多块钱吧。原来比方说挣3000多块钱，就是2000多到3000块钱，现在能达到4000多，将近5000块钱。
哦，
对，一个月。
Jianhua goes to a restaurant frequented by other taxi drivers.
不是就怕来不及。
The midday meal gives drivers a valuable opportunity to exchange information. Today, though.No one has anything but complaints.
Jianhua 神气一下，我有，我们家有车，也是老板。
The taxi drivers commiserate and complain to relieve their stress. After their short break, they go back out to face the congested roads. More than 5 million cars drive on the roads of Beijing, with more being added every day. This explosive growth is reflected in license plate numbers. Until 2003, license plates had 5 numerical digits. 3 years later, the first digit was replaced by a letter, tripling the number of possible combinations. Then, in 2012, the second digit was also replaced by a letter. There are 15 times more registered cars in Beijing today than there were 20 years ago. Their number far outstrips those in Tokyo and continues to grow. Today, despite it being the middle of the afternoon, sunlight is blocked by the thick smog that engulfs the city. The culprit is particulate matter, which comes from car exhaust and other sources. We measured particulate levels on one of the ring roads. The average level in Tokyo is less than 100, as measured by this device. We watched the reading rise to 5 times Tokyo's level. If breathed over an extended period, this level of pollution can have serious health consequences. On this day, we discover special measures being implemented at an exit on the second ring road. Officials from the Beijing Municipal Environmental Protection Bureau are regulating traffic flow and operating a special device to measure car exhaust. Using infrared light, the device provides an instant and detailed analysis of the chemical composition of car exhaust. A camera reads each car's license plate as it goes by. The purpose is to identify cars with large amounts of CO2 gas and other pollutants in their exhaust. The data is uploaded to a computer. Owners of cars that exceed prescribed levels will be notified and required to pay a fine. This car emits large amounts of CO2 gas. It's an old foreign-made car. Being around 20 years old, it was built before current emission standards were adopted. On this day, less than 1% of all cars measured exceeded emission standards. The problem of particulate matter is really simply due to the overwhelming number of cars on the road. 30秒钟. But how do Beijing residents feel about the air pollution?
你好，你好，你好。那个，就天又热，好像这个空气好像透明度也不行。 车太多了吧？车太多了。车的就车牌子费。
PM2.5。
您知道？
太简单了，这问题是全世界都知道。
具体来说是来自于什么方面？
尾气污染吧，主要的。我觉得还是汽车尾气主要的，还有。
你大家伙这空气污染了，全都肺上有毛病了，然后医药费就上去了，国家负担更重了，
对，
是不是？这样更不好。
我们现在想骑自行车，但是又没有合适的路可以骑。
对对对，
骑自行车，你看这车开那么快，没有专门的道路，很危险。我们曾经的，我们中国是自行车大国呀。
是啊。
我们那时候骑自行车，看看风景，有新鲜的空气，
现在的蓝天白云，你上哪儿找去？找不着了，蓝天白云，污染太厉害了，我们都深受其害，是不是？真的深受其害。
Currently, an expressway is rapidly being constructed that connects the 4th and 5th ring road.In recent years, an enormous bedroom community has sprung up on the east side of Beijing, with residential areas being built in quick succession. The new expressway connects this suburb with the city. When it's completed, an additional 100,000 cars will flood into Beijing every day.The rising tide of cars has changed the look of the city. Pedestrians and bicycles used to rule the roads. Now, they've been sidelined by cars in sometimes dangerous ways. Shortly after 3 PM, a quarrel erupts between a bicyclist and motorcyclist right below a ring road.Apparently, the motorcyclist hit the bicyclist while weaving through cars.
You just look at my car, do you?
Ah, look at my car, look at my
car. You look at my car,
do you? Look at my car, look at my car. You say, how to do it? Don't go,
don't
go. Ah, we don't go, we don't go. Ah, you call the police, can't you? Don't go, don't go.
Don't go, you call the police, you call the police.
The man on the bicycle says that he faces dangerous conditions every day. He finds it difficult to control his anger.It's 5 o'clock in the afternoon at the Beijing Traffic Monitoring Center. At about this time of day, a drastic change occurs in another Beijing transportation system. There are 16 subway lines beneath the city streets. During the evening rush, passenger volume jumps by a factor of 10.The municipal government has focused on developing the subway system as a way to relieve traffic congestion. Shortly after 5 o'clock, the subway entrances and exits are jammed with people. Line 1 is the oldest subway line.Taking a ride, we discover something surprising. The subway cars are narrower than those used in Tokyo. Beijing has revised the schedule so that trains run every 3 minutes, but even so, the lines are already operating at full capacity. Dr. Wang, the transportation engineer,doesn't believe that existing subways can solve Beijing's transportation problems.
这条地铁线路当初是出于军事目的修建的，所以没有太考虑公共交通的作用。这条地铁线路的站台比较深，站台也比较窄，站台的长度也比较短，所以地铁的边长比较短，使用的地铁车辆也比较小。这样的话，这条地铁就没有办法起到一条干线铁路的作用，来完全的取代路面交通。
New lines are being built with the goal of doubling the number of lines from 16 to 32 by 2020. Construction costs will climb to about $8 billion per year. In the summer of 2013, another kind of new installation appeared here and there throughout the city. These racks of public bicycles are provided by the municipal government. People who register can use them anytime.
师傅，不好意思，那个您是经常利用这个车吗？
偶尔吧。
偶尔。那为什么你想骑这个车呢？
一个是方便，一个是离我们家近。
还有什么其他原因？
比较经济实惠，再一个是环保吧，主要是环保。车不开了，车在上面加加的。
您是去哪儿的？
好，没有事吧？好，不要，好，再见啊。
您走吧，走吧，
好，
上吧。再见啊。
什么时候还过来啊？
好。
City officials hope that the bicycles will help reduce traffic congestion. Currently, there are more than 500 bicycle stations installed throughout the city. They contain 5,600 bicycles. Riders can return the bicycles to any rack. Bicycles tend to accumulate near stations where people congregate. City employees must go around to collect them and take them back by motorcycle to other racks. It's a labor-intensive approach to reducing congestion, but public reaction appears to be positive. Plans call for an increase to 1,000 bike stations in 2 years. It's 6 o'clock. During the evening rush, traffic grinds to a halt for the third time in the day. Jianhua, the taxi driver, is on an ordinary street in the western part of the city. His passenger is a woman who's going shopping. She's heading for a neighborhood of clothing wholesalers about 20 kilometers away.
咱是走长安街呢，还是走二环过去呢？
走二环吧，二环顺一点，就直接就扎过去了。
好的，那就是朝阳门桥盘上去，完了。
朝阳门，我们是。
Jiahua checks the traffic report on his radio.
我们来关注一下最新的路况。目前在西二环广安门桥附近门桥南向北方向车流相对集中，机场高速进京方向北高到古园桥路段车多。现在在北部地区还是有。
这点我觉得还行，这个车。本来我打算走地铁的，我觉得这点可能二环不会堵吧。
二环要是堵，应该是走那，应该就是光明桥那边有点堵，应该是。
Jiahua chooses his route on the basis of the traffic report.
因为咱们现在生活的这个空间，这个有点太差了。
确实。
哎，确实需要全民进行一下那个，互相维护这个吧。
每个人都要做出自己
的贡献，所谓的贡献就是一点一滴的，就是说我有可能牺牲了我个人自由，哎，导致呢就是天空能变得更蓝一点。所谓的个人自由的时候，
肯定是在其他的新岗位在做您的新贡献，是吧？您提供的信息、
啊。应该说就是我们这个团队里边吧。
那真是太感谢。您经常遇到哪一块不好走的时候，一定要听交通台。
Using traffic reports, Jiahua manages to get through the center of town and arrive at the destination without difficulty. The fare is a little over 60 yuan, or about 10 US dollars.
100的打得开吗？
打得开。
嗯，那给您100的。
This is decent income for his last fare of the day.
今天雨没怎么下，估计晚上才下。
说是晚上有雨。
是吧？你早收回也行。
对。走，您慢走，带好东西。
谢谢您。
哎，不客气。
好好好。谢谢，再见。
南好东三五回家。东便门桥下目前是由南向北的内侧道有故障车，提醒后车注意，完毕。
Jiahua has dropped off his last passenger of the day.But on his way back to the taxi depot, he continues to provide traffic information to the radio station. Near midnight, Beijing streets undergo yet another transformation. The city is flooded with trucks carrying fresh food.
都中的那个打通，就是用什么东西？
什么？
今天用什么东西？
打通啊？
哦，是，对。
欢迎什么东西啊？
是都是打通吗？
啊，都是打通。
哦。重量是多少
？The driver says he's from Shandong Province. He's driven 600 kilometers in 8 hours to get here.This is the entrance to Fifth Ring Road, which runs in a huge loop around the city. He passes through the gate at exactly midnight. He checks the time carefully. There's a special reason why this is so important. The sign says Green Road. Green roads are reserved exclusively for trucks that carry vegetables, fish, and other fresh produce. Long-distance trucks are not allowed to enter Beijing during the day. They can only use the roads between midnight and 6 a.m. The driver heads for the center of the city at the maximum speed allowed for trucks.
行，我到门口打电话啊。
He arrives at one of the world's largest wholesale produce markets. About half of all the fresh foods consumed by the 20 million residents of Beijing pass through here. Another driver he's been talking with by cell phone pulls in. They begin unloading immediately. The long-distance trucks must be off Beijing streets by 6 a.m. It's a race against time.
这种红的品种好。These
peppers just arrived from a distant province. Produce from all over pours into the market. Wholesale trucks filled with produce head out to all parts of the city. The late night market creates yet another flurry of traffic in what most would consider the off hours. Beijing is known for some of the worst traffic conditions in the world. Will people be able to bring them under control?
To根本解决城市交通问题，只有依靠加强公共交通。 北京市正在大量修建地铁，也导入了公共自行车，但这些的完成都需要10年以上的时间。到目前为止，北京市采取了很多的解决交通堵塞的问题的方法，但还没有从根本性上解决城市交通拥堵的问题。 另外，北京市的道路网络中比较缺乏毛细道路，个别的道路和桥梁的构造也有问题。在这些问题基础上，北京市的司机开车缺乏礼仪，缺乏交通安全教育，所有这些原因结合在一起，使得北京市的交通问题越来越变得深刻。
美好一天从现在开始，欢迎收听正在为大家直播的1039新闻早报。大家早上好，我是婉乔。6:48，我们先来插播一下路况。今天呢是周二，我们在我们的这个路况当中说到了西南三环丰益桥，内环方向内侧呢是刚刚发生了多车追尾的一个事故，也请途经的司机朋友们。
Like every morning, traffic jam reports are broadcast on radios as cars head into town.
总台好，035附加。杨桥桥下目前是南向北，行驶缓慢，排队大约在500米左右，完毕。这就是整个全过程，这就是一个。
For taxi driver Cui Jiehua, another day of battling gridlock begins.
文化，比如说我现在原来咱们就骑自行车，你逐渐走上开汽车了，那么开汽车你不可能用开骑自行车的那种方式去对待嘛，在马路上去行走，这个呢一个这么大的一个飞跃，跨度的飞跃，所以需要一个这堵车呀缓解也需要一个时间，等人们都意识到这个问题了之后，哎，都认识到了，哎呦，我开车我要规矩，我要懂得怎么样开车，懂得文明去开车，哎，到那个时候，我想呢，交通会比现在更好。不是说我今儿明天睡醒一宿觉之后，立马我变成了，哎呦，交通顺畅了。
时候相当的见成效，
对，那个时候一点也不堵，走了，
谢谢，
好嘞。
Beijing's traffic jams are generated by unlimited energy and desire. When will they ever be tamed?Today, like yesterday, residents renew their struggle to move through congested streets with no exit in sight.
NHK World, your eye on Asia.